Hi, it's Mary. Welcome back to the Paper Turtle. Welcome if you're new. Thank you for joining me. I am working in the giveaway journal. And I was sitting here playing, and once again, I thought, why don't I turn the camera on so that you can see what I'm doing? Sometimes when I come in here and I start playing, I just kind of want to play. You know, I don't want to worry about filming or recording. I keep telling myself, Mary, there's no film. There's no film. You're recording. You're not filming. But that's old school. Anyway, so I come in here to play, and I just want to play by myself, kind of. But then I get into it, and I start working on things, and I think, I really should turn the camera on so that they can see what I'm doing in their journal. So that's what I'm doing. I've decided to turn the camera on. What I did earlier, where is it? Here it is. What I did earlier when I first came in here that you missed was this. I had this white page and I wanted to cover the white page somehow. So I took this piece of double-sided scrapbook paper and I just made a flip out and a flip down with a pocket, and I made the tag. And this is also a pocket up here. So that's what I started with this morning. This will get decorated a little bit. The tag will get decorated later on. It's got journaling space on the back. So I did that first. And then I'm flipping through trying to figure out, okay, what do I do next? What do I do next? So I came to this page. Now, if you watched the video where I was preparing the journal pages, you know that I used some 12 by 12 paper in here. And of course, if you fold 12 by 12 paper in half, it's only 6 inches wide. And I wanted it to be wider than that. So I took two pieces of 12 by 12 paper and I pieced them together so that I could have a wider paper. And this particular one, you can see I folded it here. Right. There's a 12 by 12 piece of paper. This is also a 12 by 12 piece of paper. So I folded this one and I attached it here. And there's a little pocket here. Not a big pocket, just a little pocket there. I could have made it bigger, but I glued it wrong, so it's a little pocket, which is okay. And then on the other page, it flips. Now right here was the back side of this page. And as you can see, if you can see, there's writing on the back of the page with a barcode and the name of the paper company. Well, I don't want that on there. Who wants to see that? Sorry, whoever you are, Daisy Papers. I don't want to see that. So on this side, I just covered it with this strip of paper to make a pocket. And over here, I'm going to put a corner tuck spot. So I dug into my scraps again, and I came up with this piece of scrapbook paper. It was like this. It was a half a piece of paper. I don't know what I'd use the other half for, but I thought, well, this is perfect. And that's about when I thought, let me turn the camera on. But I did do the fussy cutting before I turned the camera on. So I fussy cut the corner of the paper to get this. And this is going to go right here. And that will be a corner tuck spot. What do you think? I like it. It's okay if this is white. It can be white. I'm actually going to ink the edges of this, I think, so that it just gives it a little bit of color. But I like it. I don't know. I like how it looks. I think I'm going to glue this leaf down. And then the tuck will be here. Or should I not glue that down? I'm not going to glue it down. Okay. I just had to figure out where I was gluing. So that is where I'm at. And that's where I'm picking up and starting this video because I gotta get this book done. I feel like I have been working on this forever, and this is what happens when I make a journal. It takes me a long time to make a journal because, I mean, I don't have all day every day to come in here and work on these journals. I wish I did. So it takes me a long time. And I did take, not a break from it, but I did take some time to do some scrapbooking because I'm like way behind on that. And I really just felt like doing some scrapbooking. So there were a couple days, a few days where I was doing scrapbooking instead of journaling. So that kind of took time away from it. But hey, you got to do what you enjoy doing. Otherwise it becomes a chore. And I certainly don't want this journal to become a chore. I'm enjoying making this journal. And I want to continue to enjoy making the journal. And when it's done, that's when I'll give it away. And I hope that you're being patient with that because, well, you don't have much choice. So I'm using, this is old paper, which is what I used around this thing here. And it's kind of a, almost got a greenish tint to it. I like it in the, you know, in the right setting. It's not like a coffee dye. It's greener. But I like I said, I like it. So I feel like it's been ages since I've actually done a video. And again, I don't know when this will end up going up. it seems to take me a long time after I record a video to get it actually out there. And I don't know why. It just does. Okay, so that is that page. Now what I'm doing with this journal, and maybe that's why it's taking me so long, I'm not doing like all the decorating at this point. Right now I'm going through and I'm taking a look at what the pages need. Does it need a pocket? Does it need a tuck spot? Does it need something else? And that's kind of what I'm doing right now. In my off time, I'm making ephemera to go in the journal. I hope. So once again, I turned the camera on with no plan of action here. Basically, I'm flipping through and I'm seeing, okay, what do I need to do on what page? Now, I did have something that I stuck in here. I put a bookmark in here because I was going to do something on this page. I have no idea what I was putting on this page. Excuse me, my throat is froggy again. But I'm leaving the bookmark in here in case I remember what it was I was going to do so that I can do it. I'm guessing it was something on here because this is another blank white page. But I don't know what. So we'll return to this. Back here somewhere, I have stuck in the page. Here it is. This. This is, I think it's a collar. Picked this up at a sale somewhere. And I was thinking I could put it like on the page, like this, right? And make it like a little pocket right here. It just needs to be glued down. I think that that would look really super cute. What do you think? And I don't mind if these ends stick out a little bit. I like it. I'm going to do it. And I think I'm going to use this because it sticks down fabric and trim and stuff better than the white glue, I think. Okay, so I don't want to glue like this corner or this corner. So like three scallops down. Wait, am I doing it on the right side? Yeah. I guess they're both the same. Yeah. Okay. Two, three scallops down. So I'm just going to put this along the edges and hope that that will be enough to tack this down so that I can use it like as a pocket. I'm going to have a lot of pockets and things to put in here. No, 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 Mary. Oh, I'm doing it wrong. I don't want to glue this end. I want to glue this end. Oh, crap. Do you see what happens when I turn the camera on? Oh, my gosh. Can I save it? I hope so. Oh, my God. I might have to come back to this after the glue dries. That was like, I'm so glad that I caught that before I stuck it on the page. What a dingbat. Oh my goodness. I'm just, see, I'm talking. I'm not paying attention. All right. That needs to dry because it needs to dry. All right. Let me put a bookmark in this page, so see if I can remember what the bookmark is for. I'm going to set that aside right for a minute to dry, and we'll move on. Wow, that was weird. Okay, we're not doing that. What else do I want to do? What else do I need to do in this page, in this book? Oh, I did this the other day. It's a belly band, and I love it. I think it came out just so cute. What do you think? I really like it. I was excited when I did that. I get excited when I do something and I like it. All right. So let me see. One day, and I'm not going to do it today because I have to prepare for it and I'm not prepared for it right now. We are going to do, we're going to make a tassel for here and we're going to do beads or something on here. But we're not doing it today because I don't have my stuff out. I'm not prepared to do it. So we're not. Okay. Let me take a look at each signature. The first signature, you know, I always start at the beginning and go through. And so the first signature always has more stuff. The last signature always has fewer stuff. But we've got a few things of trim on the edges. I know I probably put trim on the last video I did, but it's one of those things that I can do pretty quickly. So there's trim on the edges there. You know what? I wanted to do something on these wrapping paper pages. And you know, one thing that I thought of doing is making a window pocket with the acetate so that you can see what's behind the window. You can see the paper behind the window. See the man behind the curtain. Where did I put my acetate? Not necessarily acetate. It doesn't have to be acetate. Just clear, something clear to go on there. It could be vellum too. All right, what is this stuff here? This will work. Okay. I don't know if you can see this. This came out of a book that needs to be wiped down. When I was working way back when, I've been retired for almost 6 years now. Yes, it has been over 6 years now. Do you believe that? Gosh. I am not old enough to be retired for 6 years. I'm not, really. Because technically, I didn't retire. I just quit working. But anyway, when I was working, we had investment managers come in and give presentations. And they always had these booklets. Before I left, I wasn't doing junk journaling then. I was just scrapbooking then. Before I left, I took apart a bunch of those booklets. They were just going to get thrown away or recycled. So I took apart a bunch of them, and in those booklets was some acetate paper. I also got a bunch of blank paper that's like really good quality. And a lot of that stuff I think I got rid of when I moved, because I had a huge stack of it. And I think I got rid of most of it when I moved, because I don't know where it is. If I kept it, I think I didn't keep it, but I kept some of these. So I'm going to make a pocket, a clear pocket right here. And what I need to determine the size, which I'm going to make it like not the whole width of the paper, because what I'm going to do is to attach it. I'm just thinking this through as I'm doing this. I've never done this before. So I'm just thinking it through as I'm doing it. But I need to attach it. And to attach it, I'll want to cover the edges, because I don't want to see the glue underneath it. So I want to leave room on the page. I think maybe I'll do... I'm going to do 5.5 by, again, I need room at the bottom. Let's say 4.5, 5. Does it matter? Let's do 4.5. 5.5 by 4.5. is the size that I'm going to cut this. I'm winging this. 5.5. Ooh, that slides. By 4.5. Okay, that's going to be the pocket itself. Now, I have to decide, what do I want to cover the edges with once I have this glued in here? I mean, I'm going to make a notch, not that you're going to be able to see it, but just in case. I can't see what I'm doing. That'll work. Okay, so I'm thinking some kind of trim, maybe. But it has to be flat trim. I'm going to grab my box of trim, my flat trim, and we'll take a look and see what's in there that I like. All right, my trim, I'm going to move this for a second. To show you my box of trim. In the top I have bags of miscellaneous trim remnants, I guess. I'm just going to take those out. Unless I want to use this GIMP. No, I don't want to use that. And then here's my... I don't know how much of this you can see. Let me see. Can you see? I don't know. I gotta put you back down now. I hope I got you in the right spot. Okay, so I'm gonna move this. I have drawers. next to me over here, and I pull out a drawer and I set this thing on the drawer, and then it's at my waist height and I can go through it and pick out what I want. All right, so do we want pink? That doesn't quite go, does it? This one might go. So I have these trims on cards like this, sorted as much by color as I can. And when I buy this stuff, you know, I buy it at I buy it at the thrift stores and estate sales and stuff. So usually, not always, because sometimes I do get full things in packages, but a lot of times I get pieces. So I take those pieces, or when I've used some of a package, and I put them on these cards, and I can usually fit 3 or 4, depending on the width of the trim, on the card by color, and then they all fit in this box. Now, you can see when I pull this out, my box is full. So I need to not buy any more of this stuff because I don't need to. It's full. I have every color and shade of this trim that I can think of. So anyway, that's where my trim, my flat trim is stored. That's all the seam bindings and hem tapes and things like that. I think that this will work. I'm hoping that if I put that on there after I glue this down, that should hold it. And it should cover up any glue marks, right? All right, that's what we're going to try. Oh, I hope. Because I'm on camera. And I don't want to look like I don't know what I'm doing. Because I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just doing this for the very first time. So I'm using this clear glue. One, because I think it's the strongest of my glues. I have super glue, but I'm not using super glue. And two, because it is clear. So hopefully it will dry clear enough. I think you'll still see it through there. That's why I want to try to cover it up. But hopefully it won't, it'll minimize and it will work. Okay, so I want it up a little bit from the bottom because I want to put the trim on there. Okay. Oh, let this work, let this work. And I really don't have to sop up the excess right now because I'm going to put more on there for the trim. And I think I'll put the sides on first. Okay. That's one side. Hopefully my sides are the same size. And I am not in camera. I'm sorry. There's the other side. And then this will be the bottom. Should I go all the way across? Or should I just do where the pocket is? I'll just do where the pocket is. Okay. Bad habit. Bad habit that I say okay all the time when I'm crafting and I'm trying, I'm doing something step by step in my brain. The reason that I do that is in my brain, that step is complete. So I'm like, okay, now I can move on to the next one. And I have to, another one of those public speaking things that I need to stop doing that. That's so annoying. This clear pocket is very hard to see, and I don't know how this is going to work, like, in the book as an actual pocket. Hopefully it, once I have a tag or journaling card or whatever I'm putting in there in it, hopefully it will be like, oh, look, that's, there's a pocket there. You know what I mean? So I'm just experimenting. I think our other piece is dry. So when I'm done with this, we can go back to that. My bottle is almost empty. I do keep it upside down. I have one of those cup holders that you attach to your table, and I keep it upside down in the cup holder. My other glues don't need to be upside down yet, but when they do, that's where they go. Not crazy about the ends, but you know, I'm not gonna miter corners. You could, if you really want that nice crisp finished line there, but I'm not going to. I think it's fine without mitering corners. All right, let's let that dry, and we'll see how that ends up. I'm going to put a piece of wax paper on this page so I can turn the page. Okay, and then we're going to go back to this page. I'm going to try this again with this. Thankfully, I did not ruin it. That was kind of dumb. What? Let's try it again. Let me move this stuff. This side is what we want to put glue on. Much easier to put glue on this side. I hope this works. Never done this before either. You're getting all kinds of new stuff in this book. But you know, that's the fun of having a junk journal. And people say, well, what do you do with it? Well, sometimes you don't need to do anything with it. Sometimes it's just a thing to play in and to experiment in and have a little fun in. You don't have to do anything with it. Use it as your experimental experimental stuff. That's what I want to do next. I think I want to do one book where I just do experimental stuff, and it's just a great big fat book with stuff in it. You know what I mean? As opposed to having it have like a purpose or something. And that's, I think that's what I want to do for a journal at some point in time. I do have a sample book that I use, and I put it in the wrong place. That's all right. I do have a sample book where I put samples of stuff in, but it's getting full. It's getting like really chunky. And it's also the book that I keep track of swaps and racks and happy mail and stuff like that. So I don't want to fill it up with too much stuff because I got glue everywhere. Because I want to leave space to have the, to be able to do that, to keep track of the happy mail and stuff. Wow, this was messy. That was really messy. I don't know if there's a less messy way to do that. I got glue everywhere. I need something hard to put under here. I suppose I could wrap these around. Yeah, they just look like wings. I'll just leave them hanging. I like them hanging better. But this side now is wrinkly from the glue. So I'm gonna let that dry and see what this side looks like. If I don't like it, if it's wrinkly like this again, I'm going to, when it's dry, I'll put something on here. I don't know what. Figure that out later. Maybe a pocket and some trim, or I don't know. But something, we can put something to cover up the wrinkles from the glue. So there's that. I hope that's going to be like useful. I think I need a little bit of glue right there though. What do you think? Are we going to be able to tuck something in here? I hope so, and I hope that glue isn't going to show on the edges. I mean, it's not horribly bad. It's very wet right now though, so we'll see. We'll come back to it and see what it looks like when it's all dry. I just don't want it to stick. Maybe I need another piece of wax paper. I don't know. It's all right. Okay. You know what? I don't even know what time I started this video. Oh, crap. All right, I'm going to say I'm going to go another half hour. And then however long that video is, that's what it'll be. Okay. Now what do we want to do? Let's go back to what we did the first time where I looked at the signature to see how much is in each one. So this is the first signature. I've got a little bit of trim on there. I'm feeling like I want more. Where do I want some trim? I don't want it here because this is going to be a fold out and I don't want a bumpy line here where the trim would be if somebody wants to write on here. So I'm not going to put the trim here. I could put some trim here. Now here we have a couple of blank pages, which is good for journaling. One is kind of a purpley color and the other is green. And then the ledger paper over here. So I'm thinking that this needs a little something here. Maybe I'll put some trim along here. I could put another pocket in here. Do I want to do that? The problem with me putting too many pockets is that I feel like I need to fill those pockets up. You know what I mean? And there's nothing wrong with that, but I don't want to run out of things to fill it with, you know? All right, think, Mary, think. What do you want to do? I could just do a pocket. I've got this piece of paper right here that will fit. Quite grungy looking, but it's okay. All right, Mary, just do a pocket. You can come up with something to put in the pocket. It's how big do I want the pocket? 3 inches. Yeah, we'll do about 3 inches. I think I still need that there. I always try to use scraps, as you know. We all try to use scraps. And, I think what I might do on this one, I have some things that I made, some little cluster things that I made. And I think maybe I'll put one on here. I haven't done too much decorating because, like I said, I was going to do the decorating all at one time. Like, once I get all the pockets and stuff in. But I don't want this video to be like, oh, she's just making pockets again. That's boring. I want to give you something to look at. Something more interesting than just pockets. Pockets are simple. Pockets are easy. They're like the easiest thing that you can do. You just take a piece of paper and put it in there. Easy, simple. So, I want to do something other than just putting in pockets. I'm going to show you what I made. And I'll see if I have something that will work to decorate this. I might put some trim on it too. Now what I'm going to do when I do fill the pockets, I'm going to put in some things that I've made, tags and journaling cards and stuff that can be used. I'm also going to put in things that you can use. You can remove from this book if you want. If you want to put in another book. Things that you can use to make things. Or there'll be a lot of, not a lot, but there'll be note cards, stationery. I might put some, I don't know. I have to look and see what I have. I don't have a lot of ephemera. That's one thing that I have not accumulated a lot of. So I don't have a lot of that kind of stuff to put in here. But there's other things that I'll stick some things in that you can use to make other things. All right, I'm going to grab the basket. Hold on a second. This is the thing with these craft alongs, is that I don't have all my stuff right here on my desk. I just don't operate that way because, well, my desk isn't that big. So I have to go get up and go find things to use, you know. All right, so I have this little basket here, and this is where I put tags and ephemera and stuff that I make that's ready to go into a journal. A few things in here somebody else made and sent me. So like this these were sent to me. Those are going in my own journals probably, just because I like them. But there's other things in here that I made. that, like I said, they're ready to stick into a journal. So what I was looking for, what I was thinking of, were these cluster things here that I made at some point. I thought I would stick one of those on here, but I also have these little hidden journaling things that I made. We did these in a video, but I don't think I'm going to put one of those on here. This is just a journaling card that I made. I don't know. This can go on a page. See, I already put some of this stuff in here. I did put some of this stuff in here because we made them on video. So what I was looking for was these. This is a little notepad. Isn't that cute? I like how that came out. So I thought I'd put one of these on. I kind of like that one. Yeah, I like that one. Okay, so these are just little clusters that I made. What I used as the backing, it appears, is my master board collage sheet thingy that I made a while back. I had cut it up and these were little pieces, so I used those as the back on them. And I just glued on trims and little pieces of fabric and buttons. This one's got some paper and flower, and I like that one too. Oh, Mary, just pick one. Okay. So that's going to go on there. I'm trying to think of what my strongest glue is. Actually, I'm going to use this again because this is kind of heavy. It's got the buttons and everything on it. So now when we get to decorating like this, this is what's going to make this journal bulky. And I want it to be all bulky and fun. What do you think? Do you want it to be really bulky? Or do you want it to be not so bulky and thin so that you can do more of your thing in it? Let me know what you would prefer in this. Okay, that's that. Could go in there, I guess. It's just a journaling card. And I do think I'm going to put some trim on it. So, ow! Oh, I just banged my knee. I got a new chair. A very nice chair. It does not squeak like my old chair did. But the problem with my new chair is it's bigger and it takes up more space. And I really need to rearrange in here so that I have a little bit more wiggle room over here. And I think I'm going to use this trim that's on here. Let me see. So I like my chair because it's comfortable, but it really does take up a lot of space. And yep, that'll work. Okay, I need to move my box again. This is the problem. Everything has to be moved so I can move. I need a bigger room, is what it all boils down to. I just need a bigger room, which is impossible. I won't be getting a bigger room. There's nowhere for a bigger room to be. It is what it is. So I have to deal with it. I should have done a making ephemera video. I'll do that the next time that I'm doing it. I hope you've got your stuff and you're crafting along with me. Because really, that's kind of the point of these videos, is they're not tutorials or anything. I'm just crafting, and I just want to give you something to craft along with. That's all. So I hope that's what you're doing. So I want this trim to stick out a little bit. So I'm just going to check the back. Yep, it looks good. And then once that's dry, I'll come and I'll trim the top and the bottom there. I like it. I think that came out good. Took care of a blank page, right? Yeah. I think that looks okay on there. It is bulky, but that's okay. We like bulky. Okay, so over here, here's our clear pocket, which the glue is still wet, but it really does feel like that's gonna work. Then we have the other side, which is going to have the wrinkles on the paper. So we'll have to do something with that. Another pocket? See, I feel like I'm being very repetitive. How about, oh, I might have something here. That wouldn't quite cover it. Nope. Never mind. What is this? Did I make this? Or did this come like this? I don't know. How would I put that on there? I don't know if I don't think I would want it on the bottom though, because then you got all this hanging down here. Or do I want it on the bottom? Yeah, let's put it on the bottom. You know, somebody doesn't necessarily have to write on these pages. If they want to, they can figure out how. But they can also put pictures on them. That's probably what I would do with it. I would put pictures on it. So I'm going to put this on here. And I'm going to put it on as a pocket. So you'll have the envelope here. And you'll have a pocket here. And then you have these fold down. I don't know if I made this. This was just stuck in my stuff over there. I don't know if I made this or if this came like this. I don't feel like I made it. I don't know. But it's something you could make. It's an envelope with a piece of paper just attached to it. We could make that, right? All right, I'm going to glue that on there. Just like that, because it fits. A little snug here, but I'll put it right to the edge here. Okay. That is what we're doing. And this is how I craft. I sit here at my desk and I look around and I say, what do I see that I can use? And I just grab whatever I see. Now, on the one hand, okay, that's good. It's using the stuff. My Roomba just got stuck. That stinking Jeffrey, he just can't get his work done. Gonna fire him. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh, so I sit here and I look around and I say, what do I see that I can use? And that's what I use. Now, that can be good because it uses up whatever I happen to have here. But on the other hand, and there goes my dryer. You can tell what I'm doing today while I'm crafting housework. So, on the other hand, it's bad because I don't use up the stuff that might be hidden somewhere. There we go. So that covered up those glue marks on this side of the paper. This was wrapping paper, so it's not real thick. So when you have put a lot of glue on it like that, it's going to show through on the other side. But now we have this, which is cool, and it's a pocket. And if that will stick down there, and we have another pocket. Lots of pockets to fill in here. I don't know what I'm going to put in them, but we'll find something. We will find things. I have lots of paper and stationery and things like that that I'll put in here. And some of them, I might just put a book page from a book. Like I said, one of those things for you to use to do whatever you want with. So we'll see. We'll see how it gets filled up. I think that's going to be the really fun part, is filling up these pockets with whatever. Okay. This page here. Ooh. Signature's a little loosey-goosey here. What's going on? It's sturdy. It's stable, but it's just loose. This one here, or this one, whichever, you know, I'm going to tell you that I hope that whoever gets this does not get somehow, I don't know if you're all in frame. I hope that whoever gets this does not somehow get offended by some of the things in here. I don't know how it would offend you, but if it does, then I would apologize for it. No, I don't apologize because I'm not intentionally doing something offensive. The music paper came from, what's his name here? Fred Waring, who did a lot of patriotic music. So there's, I've noticed as I was flipping through, didn't realize it when I put the pages in, but I noticed as I'm flipping through, there's a few politically oriented things in here, and this is one of them. I think it's funny. If you're offended by that, just cover it up. Just cover it up. It shouldn't be offensive. And I've said before that I'm not going to talk politics and stuff on this page, on this channel, and I'm not. But I just want to warn you that because of the source of this book, there might be a couple things in here that maybe somebody doesn't like. I'm sorry. I did notice another page in here where it has the Pledge of Allegiance. Yeah, here it is. The Pledge of Allegiance. Obviously, if you're American, that definitely should not offend you. If it does, well, again, too bad. If you're not American and you happen to get this book and that doesn't apply to you, you don't like it, cover it up. I don't care. first of all, I'm not even going to know. And second of all, everybody's entitled to whatever. So that's just the way it is. If you don't like those things, then, you know, don't apply for the giveaway is all. You have choices. That's the beauty of freedom, is you have choices. So I just wanted to give you the information so that you could make the choice. That's all. That's all that was. Okay. Here is... Oh. Okay. I was going to do something with this. Where was I going to put it? I have a bag of a blank page. So I guess I'm putting the bag on the blank page. I don't know. Where was I going to put this? Here? But it's still very, very, very plain. What else can I do? I want to do something else besides just... I mean, I could put some trim. I put the pink trim in here yet? I have this bright pink trim. I really like it. I just want to see if I've put it in here yet, because if I have, I won't overdo it. Oh, I did. I put it here. You can't see it. I might put it here too. Let me see what else I have handy right here. I have this basket. I have lots of baskets of stuff. This is stuff that has accumulated on my table that really needs to be put away. But I stick it in this basket until I do put it away. And I just pull from it as I'm working. That's where I get my stuff. And so someday I'll put it away, and then I will accumulate more as I use other things, and it'll go in the basket and I'll use that, and then I'll put that away, and on it goes. That's how I use some of my trims. Okay, so I have a choice here. I have the pink trim, which I've already used over here. I have this trim. I don't know how this will go on the side. So I'm going to pull it out and I'm going to see. Oh, we got beads. Beads are falling off. This might not be a good choice. I need to plug up my glue. I just want to see if this will, I have a feeling that the beads will all like hang this way, you know what I mean? And it won't look good on the side like that. Let's see what it will do. If I were to put this here is what I'm thinking. When it's flat, of course, it's okay. Well, that'll work. Okay. I don't know how heavy that this is. I'm gonna try it though, because this paper is, again, wrapping paper, so it doesn't have a lot of strength to it. But we're going to try it. Because I like this trim. I think it's cool. This is going to get cut off anyway. It's fun trim. So it's going in here. I want some fun stuff. And again, I'll use this same glue, which means I will probably have to do something on the other side of the paper to cover up the glue line, but we'll figure that out too. in the right spot. Oh, that makes the page heavy. I'm going to have to reinforce it on the other side with something. Maybe I'll put some washi tape on there or something, because it's pretty heavy. I like it though. Oh, come on. Stay down here. It is not, does not want to stay in place. I feel like every time I flip it, it moves. I think it's where it's gonna be. All right, so that means I'm going to need some washi tape on the back. I think washi tape will do it. I don't know. Well, that looks pretty boho-y, doesn't it? Alright, I'm definitely gonna need something to reinforce that. I'm almost thinking, I wonder if I should put a piece of, like, not that, but a piece of paper there. Something heavier than washi tape. I'm thinking so. Piece of green. Probably don't have anything right here. What is this? That's not good. It needs to go up here. Okay. Let me grab my scrap box for me. I have a solid that I could put there, but that's kind of boring. But I don't know if I'm going to have anything else that'll work. So I might have to do the boring solid. I mean, I can always decorate it, of course. I know, you can't see me. I'm sorry. Just craft along. Just do your crafting. I'll be with you in a minute. I think I might have to do that because I don't have anything else in here that I like that's going to go. Unless I do a pink. Let me look in my pinks too. There with me. Just keep on crafting. Keep on crafting. Around here. Nope, that won't go.
Yeah, I don't think I have. Boy, I just really don't have this colorway in my scraps at all. I mean, I have lots of pinks in here, but nothing that's going to go with this overall pattern and stuff. I kind of like that. I might use that. All right. What do you think about that? You know, it would go like that. It kind of, I like it. It's got a lot, there's a lot going on, but I like it. Okay. So, I have to do this quickly because I have no idea how long we've been here. And I have a feeling that we've been here too long. I'm going to do two and, I'll do 2.5 because there's not much else you can do with this paper. 2.5 by 10. My notch, just because that's what I always do, and that's gonna, I knew that was gonna happen. I knew it before I did it. To use the green, or the, not, it's not green, old paper, kind of green, greenish. So again, I feel like I haven't made a whole lot of progress. I will keep working after I turn the camera off because I'm in the zone. I'm in the mood, and hopefully I will get a bit more done. And get this book going. I mean, it's going. It's going. I think it's it, and I love how it's turning out. I love the stuff that's going into it, and what we're doing and stuff. Well, did I measure that wrong? I sure did. Where's my scissors? I don't know how I measured that wrong. But for some reason, I did. Here I go, trying to cut a straight line. Oh boy. I just can't do it. I thought that I measured that. You know why? Because I'm hurrying. And I shouldn't be hurrying. But when I see that my time is, you know, we don't need 2 hour long videos. We really don't. I'm sure that hardly anybody is watching, and I can go to the analytics and it'll tell me.
how long people watch. And I know nobody's going to be watching for 2 hours. So hopefully, like I said, you are just crafting along and you've gotten something done in this time. And, you know, it's just the way it goes. Hopefully this is paper is enough to stabilize that. I don't know. It's kind of thin paper, but it might be enough to do what it needs to do there. Okay. If we turn the page, it's not bad. This paper's still thin, but I'm going to put this pocket on here. I still feel like this is very plain, though. I feel like it needs something. Maybe I should stencil on it. I think maybe I will. But time is up, so I'm not going to do it right now. I feel bad about saying I'm going to stencil on it and then I leave. That just doesn't seem like the right thing to do. But yeah, time's up. Okay. So I'm going to go and, I'm going to stencil on this and you will see it in another video. You'll see it in a flip through or something. Y'all know how to stencil. You don't need to watch me stencil. So yeah, we're going to go. Okay. We'll see you next time. Thanks. Bye.